Today I am going to give lecture on Fourier transform and discrete time Fourier transform. Fourier transform, it is used for non-periodic continuous time signals to transform time domain signal to frequency domain by using the formula x of omega is equal to integration from minus infinity plus infinity x of t raised to minus j omega t dt, and its inverse Fourier transform is given by x of t is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integration from minus infinity plus infinity x of omega into e raised to j omega t into d omega. To find the Fourier transform, there are certain conditions. Those are called Dirichlet's condition. The signal should satisfy these conditions, then only we can apply Fourier transform. First condition is the function f of t should be absolutely summable or integrable, and second one is f of t should have finite number of maxima and minima. Third one, the discontinuities of f of t must be finite. Next, we will solve some of the problems on some elementary signals such as impulse signal, exponential decrease signal, rectangle signal. For example, Fourier transform of impulse signal is given by x of omega is equal to minus infinity plus infinity delta of t e raised to minus j omega t dt. But delta of t is present at only one point at t is equal to 0. Therefore, integration is not required. Therefore, you will get is equal to e raised to minus j omega t slash t is equal to 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, Fourier transform of delta of t is 1 only. Similarly, Fourier transform of exponential decreasing signal is given by x of omega is equal to 0 to infinity e raised to minus at e raised to minus j omega t dt. After integration and substitution the limit, you will get x of omega is equal to 1 divided by a plus j omega. Next, we will find some of the, that is the Fourier transform of some standard signal such as rectangular signal, that is given by pi of t is equal to 1 from minus t less than equal to t is less than equal to t. This we have got x of w is equal to minus t to t 1 into e raised to minus j omega t dt. So after simplification, we will get 2t by omega t sin omega t. This is 2 into sync signal. To draw the spectrum of the signal, we have to find the magnitude and phase. So this x of omega is given by 2t into sync of omega t. So this sinc omega t is sin omega t omega t. This is 0 when omega t is equal to plus or minus n pi, or omega is equal to plus or minus n pi by 2, for n is equal to 0, 1, 2, up to infinity. So this we have got here, the signal here. Next, phase spectrum, x of omega is equal to 0 for, that is sinc omega t is greater than 0. And x of omega is equal to pi for sinc omega t is less than 0, that is negative values. For omega is less than 0, you will get plus pi. For omega negative, you will get minus pi. This is one here. So next. So to find the IDFT of a signal, we will consider two signals, delta of omega and delta of omega minus omega t. Here, f inverse of delta omega is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus n plus infinity delta of omega e raised to j omega t into d omega. This will get 1 by 2. Therefore, in Fourier transform of 1 is given by 2 pi delta omega. Similarly, Fourier transform of e raised to j omega t we got from this equation as 2 pi into delta omega minus omega naught. So these formulas are utilized to find the Fourier transform of a periodic signal. Let x of t be a signal with period t, then we can find Fourier series representation of x of t is k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of k e raised to jk omega naught t. Therefore, Fourier transform of x of t is given by k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity and x of k e raised to, or Fourier transform of e raised to j omega naught kt. So we know that e raised to j omega naught kt is equal to delta omega minus k omega. Therefore, x of omega is given by 2 pi. Here summation from k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of k into delta omega minus k omega naught. This formula is utilized to find the Fourier transform of a periodic signal. Next, we will solve some of problems on the Fourier transform of periodic signal. That is, consider the signal x of t is equal to cos omega naught t, and we have to sketch the spectrum of the signal. We know that by Euler's identity, x of t is given by 1 by 2 e raised to j omega naught t plus e raised to minus j omega naught t. Therefore, Fourier transform of this x of t is given by x of omega, Fourier transform of 1 by 2 e raised to j omega naught t plus e raised to minus j omega naught t. Then if you substitute the formula for e raised to j omega naught t, you will get x of omega is equal to pi into delta omega minus omega naught plus delta omega plus omega naught. Then we can draw the spectrum of this signal. Therefore, magnetic spectrum, it is pi for omega is equal to omega naught, and it is also pi for omega is equal to minus. This is called magnetic spectrum, and there is no phase angle here. There the phase spectrum is zero here. So similarly, for another signal, consider the square wave. It is starting from minus 1 to plus 3, 1 for 1 period. Therefore, t is equal to 4. 3 minus of minus 1 is 4, and omega naught equal to 2 pi by t is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, for this, we have to find x of k using the formula 1 by t for a period t x of t raised to minus jk omega naught t, and substitute from minus 1 to 1, height is 1 here, and from 1 to 3, height is minus 1. If substitute here and simplify, we will get here, that is 2 by k pi sine of k pi by 2. And this will be 0 for k is equal to even number 0, 2, 4, 6, and it is equal to plus or minus 2 by pi k for k is equal to odd number. Therefore, x of omega is given by using the formula 2 pi into k is equal to minus plus infinity x of k delta omega minus omega naught k. This we have got 4 by k is equal to minus infinity. That is plus or minus, we will get plus or minus here, plus or minus 4 by k, that is k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity summation delta of omega minus k omega naught t. So next, we will study some of the other signal, that is discrete time Fourier transform. That is, this is applied for the signal which is discrete in time and non-periodic. Then we are using this formula x ohm is equal to omega is equal to summation from n is equal to minus plus infinity x of n is to minus j omega n, and to find the inverse Fourier transform DTFT, x of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi for a period of 2 pi x of omega e raised to j omega n d omega. So to find the DTFT of some standard signal, delta of n, unit step function and exponential taken, to use the formula for x of omega is of 10. Therefore, here for impulse signal it is present at only one value. Therefore, here we will get for n is equal to 0, we will get x of omega is equal to 1. Similarly, for unit step function, it is present from 0 to infinity, and height amplitude is 1 here, 1 into e raised to minus j omega n. If you simplify this and apply the limit, we will get 1 divided by 1 minus e raised to minus j omega. Similarly, for exponential signal, if you substitute here, and the limit, because of u of infinity, n is equal to 0 to infinity, a into e raised to minus j omega n, get this equation. So there are some of the properties of the Fourier transform and discrete Fourier transform. One is the linearity. Here, if we add two signal and find the response, we will get the sum of the two responses. So next time shift property, the signal is shifted by time by t naught unit, then the Fourier transform will be e raised to minus j omega t naught into x of omega. If frequency shift, if you multiply signal by e raised to j omega naught t, then it is shifted in frequency by omega naught unit. In time differentiation, if you differentiate signal, then you will get transfer signal will be multiplied by j omega into x of omega. In convolution, if you perform the convolution time domain and frequency transform, that will be multiplication of two signal in the frequency domain. If the two signals are multiplied in time domain, then in frequency domain, that is after transformation, we will get 1 by 2 pi into convolution in frequency domain. Similarly, Parseval's theorem, here the power in time domain is same as power in frequency domain. Similar property can be derived for DTFT. So this is about the FTA, DTFT, the signal.